At this space, you already have a complete color at the top layer, the white color in this case, two complete layers which surround the complete color, and you also have a cross at the bottom of the cube. If you already have a complete color at the bottom, you can move to the next phase. At this phase, you have to hold the cube upside down. The cross is in front of you and the complete color is at the bottom. There are exactly four types or shapes of crosses that you may encounter in this phase. I gave them names so that it will be easier to understand. The first one is what you see here is a cross plus one corner. That's how I name it, a cross plus one corner. And the corner piece may appear at any of the corners. It doesn't matter because you can turn a layer and it will be the same. The second shape is an orphan cross. I call it an orphan cross because it's one cross without any additional corners. The third shape is 6 plus 1, that's how I call it. It's two complete lines and one edge, what you see here. Two straight lines and one edge. Shape number four is what I call two missing diagonal corners, is what you see here. It's a cross and two missing diagonal corners and two corners which are there. The other missing are here and there. In order to solve this phase, you have to perform one of two algorithms, which I'll show you. And these two algorithms are right algorithm and left algorithm, which are kind of a reflection of one another, or a mirror. You just need to know when to use each one of them and where from in the cube. And it's different for each one of the shapes, the four shapes that I told you about. And I'll show you how to do it. So let's go over each one of the four shapes of the cross and see how you move on from it. And then I'll summarize it so it will be easier for you to understand. The first shape out of four is this one, the cross plus one. And if you are in one of the other three that I'll show you and you want to get to a complete color, you first have to get to this one, the cross plus one, and I'll show you how. And only from the cross plus one you can get to a complete color. So your goal from any of the other three shapes is first to get to the cross plus one and then to a complete color. From the cross plus one, you'll always need to perform the algorithm once and you get a complete color. Start with the first case, cross plus one corner. Note that the corner can appear in any of these four places. Just need to turn it. In general, you want this corner with the color of the cross to be as close to you as possible, so it can be either here or here. If it's already here, then you can leave it there and either on the right or on the left. But how do you decide whether to use it from the right or from the left? By the color of the cross. See here you have the color of the cross on the left, and here it doesn't exist. You'll always have the color of the cross in front of you either on the left or on the right. If it's on the left, the corner is to your right. And then you perform the left algorithm, because the color of the cross, which is in front of you, not at the top, is on the left. If it was the opposite, you would do it from the right. And then instead of this red, you would have yellow, and then you would perform it from the right side. So you place the corner of the cross as close to you as possible. And how do you decide? By the color of the cross that you see in front of you. Right in front of you. Not at the top side, but in front of you. So when the corner of the cross is placed and you see the color of the cross on the left, you perform it from the left. You perform the left algorithm. Let's see it. Left. Counterclockwise. Upward, top layer, counterclockwise, to the right, left, clockwise, downward, top, counterclockwise, to the right, left layer, counterclockwise, upward, top layer twice, it doesn't matter to which direction, and left layer, clockwise, downward. And you got a complete color at the top, and some nice things here at the top layer, which are currently not important. We'll talk about them in the next phases. The most important thing is that you have a complete color at the top. Now let's see the other case. In this case, see the corner is far away from us, so we turn it, and now the corner is right next to us, but there is no color of the cross in front of us, so we turn it. Now the corner of the cross is on our left, and the color of the cross that we see at the top layer is on our right, so we perform the right algorithm. Let's see. Right. Clockwise upward. Top. Clockwise to the left. Right. Counterclockwise downward. Top. Clockwise to the left. Right. Clockwise. Upward. Top. Twice. It doesn't matter which direction. And right, counterclockwise, downward. And you got a complete color at the top. What you get at the top layer is currently not important. We'll talk about it later. If you get a complete color at this phase, you can move on to the next phase. This is only valid for cross plus one. Now let's see the other three cases. This is the second case, the orphan cross. It's a cross without any corners. Any yellow corners. In this case, you can do it from various places. You can do it either from here when there's no yellow color, there's no color of the cross in front of you. In this case, you can do it either from the right or from the left, whichever one is more convenient for you. If you want to do it from the right, you do it from the right. You want to do it from the left, do it from the left. It's okay. It will work. And if you choose to do it from this place where the yellow color, the color of the cross, is on your left, you perform the left algorithm. Okay? And if you choose to do it from the opposite side, where the color of the cross here is on your right, then you perform the right algorithm. So it's either from the left or from the right with the color of the cross, or from where there's no color of the cross. But don't ever do it from the flashlights. Don't ever do it from where you have two corners with a color of the cross. Don't ever do it. You'll waste time. After you perform the algorithm from the orphan cross, you'll get a cross plus one. And then you'll go on with the instructions that I gave you for cross plus one. And then you'll get a complete color. So let's perform the algorithm. I choose the right side in this case. It's an orphan cross, or I decide by the color of the cross, which is on my right. And it's like this. Right, clockwise, upward, top layer, clockwise to the left, right layer, counterclockwise, downward, top layer, clockwise to the left, right layer, clockwise, upward, top layer, twice, it doesn't matter which side, and right layer, counterclockwise, downward. And we got a cross plus one, and if you perform the algorithm again from this place, from this situation, then you get a complete color. The third case is 6 plus 1. As you remember, it's two lines with one edge, and it comes in two flavors. Let's see the first one. First one is the what I call the headlights, the 6 plus 1 with headlights. You see two pieces with the two corners with the color of the cross in front of you. And in this case, you can perform either the right algorithm or the left one according to your preference, and it will work either way. So you can do it either from the right or from the left, depends on you. In the second case, the missing corners are on your right and on your left. And in order to solve it, you turn it either to the right or to the left. And how do you know where to perform the algorithm? By the color of the cross again. So if the color of the cross is on your right here, then you perform the algorithm from the left. Turn it, and here, the color of the cross is on your left, yellow in this case, and you perform the right algorithm, always as far away from this corner as possible. Unlike the headlights, where you perform it either from the right or from the left. In this case, you perform it as far away from the color of the cross. Right in this case, because the color of the cross is on the left, and here the color of the cross is on the right, so you perform it from the left. So from the 6 plus 1, you get a cross plus 1, and then perform it again and get a complete color. The color of the cross is on the right hand side, so we'll perform the left algorithm. The algorithm is on the screen, so let's start. Left layer, counterclockwise, upward. Top layer, counterclockwise, to the right. Left layer, clockwise, downward. Top layer, counterclockwise, to the right. Left layer, counterclockwise, upward. Top layer twice, it doesn't matter which side. And left layer, clockwise, downward. And you got cross plus one. Perform it again and get a complete color. The fourth case is two missing diagonal corners, as you can see here. In this case, you'll have two sides of the top layer which don't have the color of the cross. We don't care about these two sides. And you'll also have two sides with each one of them will have the color of the cross. You see here one on the right, a corner with a yellow, and one on the left. You can perform the algorithm from either of these sides according to the following rule. If the color of the cross is on the right, you perform it from the left. If the color of the cross is on the left, you perform it from the right side. Let's see. In this case, the color of the cross is on the left, so we'll perform the right algorithm. So let's do it. You have the algorithm. Start. And we've got cross plus one. Now let's summarize everything. I'll start with the orphan cross. From the side, which has no color of the cross, you can do it either from the right or from the left, according to your preference. If you see the color of the cross on the left, you can do it from the left. If it's on the right, you do it from the right. Don't ever do it from the side with the headlights. That is true for orphan cross. 6 plus 1, you can see here, if you're facing the headlights, you can do it either from the right or from the left, according to your preference. If there are no headlights, from this side you cannot do it, but if you had, instead of a blue, you would have yellow, the color of the cross, you would do it from the left, as far away from the edge as possible. And here again, if instead of green, you would have yellow, which is on your left, you would do it from the right-hand side, as far away from the edge as possible. Two missing diagonal corners, you always look for the color of the cross, and if it's on your left, you choose to do it from here, so you do it, you perform the right algorithm. If it's on your right, you perform the left algorithm. Let's see, the color of the cross is on our right, so we'll perform it from the left. Now we get a cross plus one, and since the corner was on the right and we don't see the color of the cross on the left, so we turn it to the left. Now we see the color of the cross on our right and we perform it from there. And you get a complete color. You can move on to the next phase now.